Hi, we're going to be looking this afternoon at Screencast-o-matic on the Mac laptop family. So we are looking at creating screencasts that showcase evidence of learning that are going to be stored in e-portfolios, student e-portfolios. And the e-portfolio tool we've chosen to work with today is Google Sites. So soup to nuts, this screencast is going to show you how to use Screencast-o-matic on Mac laptops to create a screencast and to store it in your Google Sites ePortfolio. So let's get started. First thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to ignore the login and sign up buttons here on the Screencast-o-matic homepage. That's because we're going to be using the free version of Screencast-o-matic, which means that you don't have to sign up for an account. This is great for younger students who cannot sign up for accounts. So what you'll want to do is click on the Start Recording button. What that does is it downloads the software to your MacBook. So you do have to be able to install software on your MacBook. Standard installation procedures, double-click the box to unpack it, move it to your applications directory, and you're all set. Then you're going to want to come back to the screencast-o-matic.com homepage and click on Start Recording. It's going to launch the recorder. You can also go directly to your applications directory and launch the recorder from there as well. So now what you're seeing is you're seeing the Screencast-o-matic screen recording area. The recording area is outlined by these black and white bars. You can change them around. You can move them to get a larger screen or a smaller screen. Any side. You can see that the recording button down here, it's red. It says REC for record. It moves around as you change the recording area of your screen. Whew. So these are your options for recording a screencast in Screencast-o-matic. You can record just the screen. You can record just the webcam. Maybe you want to have your students do some reflections that don't, you know, relate to specifically anything they're working on online or on their machines, but it's just they can open up the webcam and just record personal reflections. You also might want to have a screencast where you can actually see the narrator using the webcam, and that's when you would choose both. Maximum time for a screencast in Screencast-o-matic's free version is 15 minutes. That is an awfully long time for a screencast, so you should be just fine. As you see me talking, or as you hear me talking, you can see these green bars moving next to the microphone icon. That lets you know that the narration is being picked up by your device. So let's go ahead and click the record button. 3, 2, 1, go is your countdown. So now you know that you are recording. The other way you know you're recording is because these black and white bars are now red and white. So that's one way you can tell. You can also notice that your time ticker has, it's ticking away, showing you how much of the 15 minutes you have left. Go ahead and make your recording. Do all the recording you want within that 15-minute time frame. When you're done, click on the blue pause button. And now you see the tools have changed. You can go back and continue recording where you left off, just in case you want to pause, get a drink of water, cough, whatever. You can just pause and then go back and continue recording. You can use this play button to check out what you've recorded to make sure you're happy with it. Your time signature is now, it tells you exactly how long you've been recording. Great for if you want to do something like a public service announcement, which they generally have to be exactly 30 seconds or a minute long. Or if you want to do some sort of time-bounded activity with screencasts, two-minute explanations with Mrs. Wallingford's class, something like that. You can decide that you just want to delete everything and start over with the trash can icon, but we're pretty happy with the screencast, so we're going to click Done. Now we're over in the Screencast-o-matic recording software itself, and you can see that it picked up our audio down here. We know it happened, and we've got some options for how to save this. One of the options is to upload it to Screencast-o-matic's website. This is problematic just in terms of generally you want to have some permanent record for yourself of the recording that you made, and you don't own the Screencast-o-matic web server, they do. You know, you're then dependent on them keeping their website running, and you also have the option to upload your screencast directly to YouTube. That may or may not work depending on your school's culture. If you have a school culture that works a lot with YouTube integration, that might be fine. But a lot of schools maybe just want to save the video directly to their machine. And in fact, that's what we're going to do right here. So, you'll notice a little pop-up lets us know there is a Screencast-o-matic logo watermark showing in your final video because we're using the free version. It's fine with me because I'm using the free version. But again, your school culture is what's going to, you know, let you know if that works for you guys. The type of video file you're going to be creating is an MP4. It is basically universally accepted to work on websites with many different browsers. That's what it was created for. Here at the file name, we can choose a file name that makes sense to us. So testing Screencast-o-matic that MP4. Decide where you want to save it to. You could either navigate to where if you have a specific file structure, or in this case, we're just going to save it to the desktop. This right here, this option is you can in fact highlight your cursor, which is great if you're doing something like you want your viewer to follow along step by step, and when you click something, you want them to click something, or you want them to notice specific areas in the screencast. But for this one, I'm happy just having the cursor. You also have the option of not having a cursor at all, which is great. We're all set. We're going to click publish. What that means is it's publishing to a video file, which is again being downloaded on our desktop. This is actually compressing the video into the MP4 format. Got some options here. You can play the video, you can get to the folder, or you can copy the path. Looks like we're done with the actual recording. So let us just click done. Now, the next part that we want to get to is we want this to wind up in our Google Sites. So first, we've got to get the video into our Google Drive. So we're going to go to Drive, and then you're just going to upload that video the way you would any other file. New, file upload. Navigate to where you put it. I put it on the desktop. Testing Screencast-o-matic. Sounds good. So let's choose that. You can see just kind of standard. There it is. So testing Screencast-o-matic MP4 has been uploaded to my drive. Now the last part is to move it into your Google site. So this is my Google site. It's pretty spectacular. I think we're all going to agree. Let me back out so I'll show you exactly how this works from when you navigate to your Google site. It will give you this as the starting page. You're going to want to click on Edit Page in order to put it into editing mode. Decide where you're going to insert your video. Right here looks super to me. And then you're going to go to Insert over to the right-hand column, which has Google tools in it. And then from Drive, you're going to choose Video. So there it is, testing Screencast-o-matic. How fabulous. Let's go ahead and select that. We have a URL that we could paste in there. Do we want to include the title? That's really going to be up to your students, how you want to do that. But all these look great to me, so I'm going to go ahead and save it. And there it is. I want to save my Google site. Da-da-da-da! And then it's going to take a little bit of time for Google to process the video, which I won't make you sit here and with me and wait for. But hopefully this will help you guys with using Screencast-o-matic to generate student screencasts that they can save in their Google Sites. Saving in Google Sites is great because when we were testing a lot of these screencast tools, we discovered that some screencast tools will only keep your videos for a certain amount of time and then delete them. You don't want that to happen to your students. You want them to be able to control it, download it to the machine, or better yet, save it to their Google sites. Because then you go to your school culture as to how you want those Google sites managed. Thank you very much for your time. If anybody has questions about this process, I am more than happy to talk screencasting until the cows come home, and you can reach me at Audrey, A-U-D-R-E-Y, @tarrantinstitute.org. Thank you!